1370 WOCA. Ocala.
Minutes before 9 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in this Wednesday morning. It's time for News Bites. This is the portion of AM Ocala Live during which Robin McBlain and I read the news. We take the news from the different news agencies that we subscribe to here at The Source, WOCA, and we shorten those stories so that you can hear the gist of it. We get to the point of it, and you get to go on with your lives. In the next 25 minutes, you'll hear more stories than most newscasts have in 3 hours. The first story is from Fox News, and I'll read it to you. Israel warned thousands of Palestinians living in the Gaza Strip this morning to evacuate immediately or face danger as its military continued its aerial offensive against Hamas a day after the militant group rejected a ceasefire plan proposed by Egypt. The website of the Gaza Interior Ministry said Israel warplanes carried out dozens of airstrikes before dawn this morning, targeting 30 houses, including those of senior Hamas leaders Mahmoud Zahar, Jamilia Shanti, and Fathi Hamas and Ismail Ashgar. Zahar was a key figure in Hamas's violent takeover of Gaza in 2007, while the other three were members of the Palestinian parliament elected in 2006. Many Hamas leaders have gone into hiding since the beginning of the Israeli offensive. The Israeli military had warned thousands of Palestinians living in the eastern and northern parts of Gaza to leave their homes by 8 a.m. this morning.
A suicide bomber blew up a car packed with explosives near a busy market and a mosque in eastern Afghanistan yesterday, killing at least 89 people in the deadliest insurgent attack on civilians since the 2001 U.S.-led invasion. The blast destroyed numerous mud brick shops, flipped cars over, stripped trees of their branches, brutally underscoring the country's instability as U.S. troops prepare to leave by the end of the year, and politicians in Kabul struggle for power after a disputed presidential runoff. General Mohammad Zahir Azimi, the defense ministry spokesman, said the bomber detonated his explosives as he drove by the crowded market in a remote town in Ergun district in the Pakita province bordering Pakistan. Azimi gave the death toll and said more than 40 other people were wounded, reported by the Associated Press.
The next story is from Newsmax. Republicans will grant only part of the $3.7 billion President Barack Obama requested to address a surge of migrant children at the U.S.-Mexico border, according to a statement from House Appropriations from the House Appropriations Chairman. We're trying to sift out of his request those items and dollar numbers that need to be done immediately, is the statement from Hal Rogers, a Republican from the state of Kentucky. He told reporters that statement yesterday. The rest of what he's requesting we can consider as we process the regular 2015 appropriations bills. To gain enough Republican votes, the measure will be accompanied by policy changes on border security and law revisions to speed the deportation of unaccompanied minors, according to Representative Pete Sessions, chairman of the House Rules Committee. He made that statement that he expects a fuller Republican plan to be announced sometime today.
House Republicans announced yesterday they will recommend dispatching the National Guard to South Texas and speeding Central American youth back home as their response to the immigration crises that's engulfing the border and testing Washington's ability to respond. The recommendations, to come from a working group established by House Speaker John Boehner, will set up a clash with leading Democrats who oppose changing U.S. law to eliminate automatic immigration hearings for Central American children and return them more quickly to Honduras, El Salvador, and Guatemala, where some areas are overrun by brutal gangs. With Democrats in the White House under growing pressure from immigration advocates to hold firm against the GOP approach, a solution for the growing crises of tens of thousands of unaccompanied children showing up at the U.S.-Mexico border is looking increasingly elusive, with 3 weeks left before Congress leaves Washington for an annual August recess, reported by the Associated Press.
Pay attention. The next story mentions WOCA radio in the story. I'm getting it from the Daily Intelligencer with the New York Magazine. In December, congressional Republicans held a meeting to learn how to talk to ladies without making Todd Akin-style gaffes, and it might be time to hold a similar meeting on discussing immigration. BuzzFeed reports that during a WOCA radio appearance in Ocala, Florida on Monday, Florida Republican Representative Rich Nugent said his party wants to treat the unaccompanied minors flooding across the border humanely. Believe it or not, Republicans have a heart, he said, then immediately undermined that statement with, quote, a lot of these children, quote, unquote. You know, the first caller mentioned it. You know, they're gang members, Nugent said. They're gang affiliated. The news media obviously picked up on our broadcast, Robin.
Nice.
Oh, there you go.
That's great. Daytona Beach Commissioner Carl Lentz is facing a charge of battery in the wake of a disturbance at a local strip club. The charge was filed yesterday by a Volusia County state attorney. Official documents said it pertained to an episode that took place in March. According to the charges, Lentz touched or struck a woman, a female employee, against her will. The charging affidavit detailed the allegation with the notation that Lentz allegedly threw a drink at the woman. Lentz is also alleged to have asked the woman, a server at the club, for sex in exchange for a reduction of police patrols of the club. The manager of the club wound up calling police to report the alleged misbehavior by Lentz. Lentz, when confronted by a police officer, is recorded as denying the allegations. According to the officer, Lentz claimed he was at the strip club to meet with someone for a real estate deal. The exchange with the officer was recorded on the officer's body camera. Also, as part of the exchange, the officer can be heard commenting that Lentz appears to be intoxicated, reported by the Florida News Network.
The next story is from the Associated Press. Severe turbulence struck a South African Airways plane that was heading to Hong Kong, injuring 20 people before the aircraft landed safely, according to the airline. Medics were waiting at the Hong Kong airport to assist passengers on Flight 286, which had departed Johannesburg on Tuesday. Yesterday, an infant was among the injured passengers, the airline said in a news release, and two of the people on board sustained serious injuries. The turbulence happened as the aircraft flew over Kuala Lumpur, the Malaysian capital. Interior panels of the aircraft were damaged, and the plane's cabin was cracked during the incident.
The next big thing in aviation may be really small. With some no bigger than a hummingbird, the hottest things at this week's Farnborough International Air Show are tiny compared with the titans of the sky, such as the Airbus 380 or the Boeing Dreamliner. What's got aviation geeks salivating at Farnborough, England, this year's biggest aviation jamboree that features participants from 40 countries, are the commercial possibilities of unmanned aerial vehicles, drones to most of us. Drones are more commonly known for their use in conflict areas. This week, Hamas launched for the first time an unmanned drone into Israel airspace that was shot down. But drones, which can weigh less than an ounce, have potential commercial applications that are vast. The industry, military and non-military, is growing and could, according to some, see investments of nearly $90 billion over the next 10 years, reported by the Associated Press in London.
And from CNN, a man wearing a Captain America t-shirt and camouflage shorts broke into the Kennedy compound in Barnstable, Massachusetts yesterday. When officers asked him what he was doing there, he replied, looking for Katy Perry. Officers went to the house in the village of Hyannisport after receiving a call from Ted Kennedy Jr., who said he had phoned the property from his home in Connecticut to check on his teenage son, and a stranger answered the phone. Police found a black car parked outside the home. Inside the home, they found 53-year-old James LaCroix in the kitchen, according to the police report. We need to take a little break and be right back. We'll continue with News Bites after the break. This is The Source, WOCA Ocala. Currently here, by the way, at the Paddock Mall, 73 degrees and drizzling just a little bit.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accident. Clouds and some sun today with a couple of showers and a heavy thunderstorm crossing the area, high 84 to 88. It'll be mostly cloudy tonight with a couple of showers and a thunderstorm around as well, low 71 to 75. More clouds and sun tomorrow with a couple of showers and a thunderstorm, high 86 to 90. For Friday, more sunshine, but still a thunderstorm or two around in the afternoon, high 88 to 92. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
This is a public notice. Local residents can now save thousands of dollars on their next car, truck, or SUV. It's not a tent sale, because no tent is big enough to hold this many cars. It's OcalaForSale.com. Say goodbye to sticker shock. OcalaForSale.com has thousands of vehicles with no stickers at all. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com. Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting less proofing factory surcharge or delivery fee. See website for details.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that,
I need too. My seat replaced.
Yep, we do that, too.
I need a new roofline, a new spoiler, and a new
truck.
Yep,
we can even do that, too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show, too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com.
Now is the time to take advantage of Florida Credit Union's CD specials. Our 36-month CD comes in at 1.26% APY. A 24-month is working for you at 1.0% APY. And our 12-month at 0.75% APY. All CD rate specials require $10,000 minimum. With friendly service and rates like these, it's not hard to see why Florida Credit Union has your CD options covered. Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life. Call 352-237-8222 for more information. Must act by 1/15/14.
How good does it get?
Golf has long been considered to be sport's most prestigious game, and WOCA has your connection to everything in the golf world. Every first and third Thursday at 10 a.m., tune in for Let's Talk Golf with your host, PGA professional and teacher to the stars, Jim Beckett, and operations manager for the links of Spruce Creek South, Darren Irwin, right here on The Source.
All right, 12 minutes before 9 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in. Let's return now to News Bites. The next story is from the Associated Press. The council governing a North Texas city that sits atop a large natural gas reserve rejected a bid early this morning that would have made it the first city in the state to ban further permitting of hydraulic fracturing in the community. Denton City Council members voted down the petition 5-2 after 8 hours of public testimony, sending the proposal to a public ballot in November. Fracking involves blasting a mix of water, sand, and chemicals deep into the underground rock formations to release trapped oil and gas. While the method has long stirred concerns about its effects on the environment and human health, industry proponents argue that fracking can be done safely and is cleaner than other forms of energy extraction.
The union that represents most of the teachers in Florida is going to court to try to block a new law that provides more money for private school vouchers. Joanne McCall with the Florida Education Association says the language expanding the corporate tax credit voucher program was added to an unrelated bill dealing with special education students and then approved on the final day of the legislative session. This is her quote. This attempt to salvage the expansion of the CTC voucher program by attaching it to this bill is disingenuous to the public and to those of us who have dedicated our lives to serving disabled students. The practice of combining unrelated bills is known as log rolling. Technically, it is illegal, but lawmakers can get away with it if no one calls them out in court, reported by the Florida News Network.
And from the Star Banner, the Ocala City Council unanimously approved an ordinance that bans sagging pants on city-owned property. If anyone is seen drooping their pants below their natural waistline, they can be stopped by police and given a warning or a fine and may face up to 6 months in jail. But the fine amount, as well as what defines below the natural waistline, still has not been decided. According to Ocala City Council member Mary Sue Rich, She tried to ban people from walking around with sagging pants on city property in 2009, but did not have the support of the council members. This time around, she did.
A report from the Florida Department of Law Enforcement details an investigation that was intended to look into whether two officers of the Fruitland Police Department were involved with the Ku Klux Klan. Officials say the investigation turned up something extra and may have opened the books on a bizarre chapter in the overall story of this particular investigation. For one thing, FDLE officials said in their report that it appears a third employee of the police department was linked to the group as well. Informants to the FBI had already said Deputy Police Chief David Borst and Officer George Honeywell were members of the KKK. The third party involved was Honeywell's wife. Honeywell's wife, who had worked at the police department as a secretary, reportedly admitted to investigators that she and her husband were members of the KKK. Despite reportedly being identified as a member of the Klan by another woman, she claimed to investigators that she and her husband never believed in the organization's philosophy. In fact, Honeywell's wife claimed she and her husband got into the local Klan chapter as part of another investigation altogether. FDLE authorities said she told investigators that she and her husband were part of a departmental investigation into the behavior of another person, Mark Isom, who was chief of the Fruitland Park Police Department at the time. It is not known at this time where this account may take any investigation. As matters stand, Officer Honeywell was fired Friday. Deputy Chief Borst resigned a day before Honeywell was fired. The state attorney's office said it was reviewing cases handled by the two men in order to see if there might have been any racially motivated charges, reported by the Florida News Network.
And from Newsmax, Paul Babu, the sheriff of Pinal County, Arizona, has defended his decision to publish the location where a group of illegal immigrant children from Central America were being housed. According to a report from CNN's Anderson Cooper 360, yesterday Babu said he was concerned that some of the children may have been older teenagers with gang connections, or some may have had disease that would have threatened the health and safety of nearby residents. According to the Tucson Sentinel, a tip from Babu to a local activist sparked a protest similar to the one last week in Murrieta, California, where the buses never arrived. The 40 to 60 children were set to be housed at a ranch for troubled minors near Oracle, Arizona, about 100 miles north of the Mexican border.
Dwayne Wade is staying with the Miami Heat, and his latest deal is designed to give both the player and the only franchise he's ever known some flexibility in the coming years. Wade signed a new contract with the Heat yesterday. It's a two-year deal, the second of those seasons a player option. The person spoke to the Associated Press on condition of anonymity because neither side announced terms. This is a quote from Wade. "I am proud to have spent every single day of my career as a member of the Miami Heat and to have brought three championship titles to this great city. I've been here through the good times and the hard times. I have confidence in the Miami Heat organization and the team they are building," unquote. Earlier yesterday, Wade tweeted, "Home is where the heart is, my home, my city, my house." He attached a photo of himself standing below the three NBA championship banners that hang at Miami's home arena. Financial terms were not announced, though it's expected Wade's salary for next season will not reach the $20.2 million that he would have made under his previous contract, reported by the Associated Press.
And this is from Health Day. Seniors in America are suffering fewer strokes regardless of their race or sex, according to a new long-term study. We found that stroke incidence among those 65 years old and older has been declining for the last 20 years, According to a senior study, author Dr. Joseph Koresh, a professor of epidemiology at the Johns Hopkins Bloomberg School of Public Health in Baltimore, he said, quote, our study found that the decrease is happening in whites and blacks, which is very important because blacks are at an elevated risk of stroke. However, people younger than 65 continued to suffer strokes at about the same rate, although the researchers found that more of these younger patients survived their stroke. The death rate from stroke for people aged 65 and older held steady. One expert found some of the study results troubling, saying, quote, the more concerning news is the lack of decline among those under 65.
A canon lawyer alleging a widespread cover-up of clergy sex misconduct in the Archdiocese of St. Paul and Minneapolis, Minnesota, has made her most detailed claims yet, accusing archbishops and their top staff of lying to the public and of ignoring the U.S. bishop's pledge to have no tolerance of priests who abuse. Jennifer Hasselberger, who spent 5 years as Archbishop John Nienstedt's archivist and top advisor on Roman Catholic Church law, has also charged that the church used a chaotic system of record keeping that helped conceal the backgrounds of guilty priests who remained on assignment. Hasselberger said that when she started examining records in 2008 of clergy under restrictions over sex misconduct with adults and children, she found nearly 20 of the 48 men still in the ministry. She said she repeatedly warned Nienstedt and his aides about the risk of these placements, but they took action only in one case. As a result of raising alarms, she said she was eventually shut out of meetings about priest misconduct. She resigned last year, reported by the Associated Press.
Also from the Associated Press, it's not easy to find models with disabilities in advertisements for the fashion and beauty industry unless you look in the Nordstrom catalog. The company has been using models with disabilities since 1997 and continues the tradition in its annual July catalog, which kicks off the upscale retailer's largest event of the year with preview discounts of new fashions for fall. This summer's Nordstrom Incorporated catalog includes, among others, a woman in a wheelchair modeling boots and a man with a prosthetic leg modeling Nike running shoes. Hiring professional models with disabilities has become so much of a part of the Seattle-based company's DNA that its regular customers may not even realize how unusual it is.
Pregnant women have new protections against on-the-job discrimination. The Equal Employment Opportunity Commission has updated 30-year-old guidelines to make clear that any form of workplace discrimination or harassment against pregnant workers by employers is a form of sex discrimination. It is illegal. Despite much progress, we continue to see a significant number of charges alleging pregnancy discrimination, and our investigations have revealed the persistence of overt pregnancy discrimination, as well as the emergence of more subtle discriminatory practices. This is a quote from EEOC Chairwoman Jacqueline A. Berrien. The guidelines prohibit employers from forcing pregnant workers to take leave. They acknowledge that employers may have to provide light duty for pregnant workers. After childbirth, lactation is now covered as a pregnancy-related medical condition, and it's not just the women who will benefit, reported by the Associated Press.
And this from CNN. Comcast never wants a customer to go, but says one of its representatives went too far trying to convince one account holder to stay. Yesterday, the cable company apologized to Ryan Block and his wife, Veronica Belmont, after the couple's attempts to cancel were stymied by a phone call with a customer service representative that Block called straight up belligerent. The incident garnered attention because Block and Belmont posted a partial recording of the conversation on the internet. In the 8-minute recording, the unnamed Comcast employee badgered Block with questions such as, why is it you're not wanting to have the number one rated internet service, number one rated television service available? In the employee's defense, he explained one of the reasons for his questions. If we don't know why our customers are leaving, how are we supposed to make it a better experience for you next time? The recording went viral yesterday morning, partly because the prominence of Block and Belmont. Block, a former editor for Engadget, works for AOL, and Belmont is a web show host and writer.
Republican leaders in the state of Florida legislature says they'll abide by the decision of a Tallahassee judge who ruled against them in a reapportionment lawsuit. Judge Terry Lewis says congressional districts 5 and 10 in Central Florida are classic examples of partisan gerrymandering and the lines need to be redrawn. Senate President Don Getz says they'll do it. The judge has thoughtfully and deliberately looked at districts 5 and 10. He has found that they need to be redrawn. It seemed to me to be the logical thing to do exactly what the judge has ordered, a quote from Getz. Getz says that they can live with the ruling because the judge only threw out 2 of the 27 congressional districts. Getz and House Speaker Will Weatherford say the legislature will follow the judge's order and redraw the lines for District 5, represented by Democrat Corrine Brown, and District 10, the home turf of Republican Dan Webster, reported by FNN.
And that's all the time we have for News Bites. How many stories today, Robin?
Let's see.
All right. 22. Yeah. All right, we'll be right back. This is WOCA Ocala.
Fox News Radio, I'm Lillian Wu. Fighting intensifies a day after a failed ceasefire between Hamas and Israel.
Palestinians living in the north and some parts of the east received text messages or leaflets warning them that they live in an area where rockets are being fired from and the Israelis are planning airstrikes. They're calling on residents to evacuate the area. Thousands are sheltering in schools run by the UN Refugee Agency.
Fox Radio's Emily Wither.
208 Palestinians have been killed in the fighting and nearly 1,500 injured. The first Israeli was killed yesterday.
The Texas woman who pled guilty to sending ricin-laced letters to the president and former New York City Mayor Michael Bloomberg getting a sentencing hearing today, and 2 Moscow subway workers detained in the investigation into the derailment that killed 22 people yesterday. Fox News, we report, you decide.
When your battery goes out on you, it's like a sucker punch to the gut. But now at Napa, when you buy a new battery, alternator, or starter, you get a Visa rebate card by mail for up to $25. And a Visa rebate card for up to $25 with a new battery? Well, that's like a sucker punch to the gut, but from a really pretty girl. Conquer the job with Napa know-how. At participating Napa Auto Parts stores, offer expires 7/31/14.
And now, another golf confessional brought to you by Golfsmith. To avoid spending the day on the lake, a man told his family it was infested with sharks, so he could go to Hot Deals of Summer at Golfsmith, where you'll find the lowest prices of any golf store, guaranteed. And it's on dry land. During Hot Deals of Summer, get a set of Nike VRS Covert 2.0 irons and get a Nike VRS Covert 2.0 driver, absolutely free. Only at Golfsmith. Anything for...
Hi, I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
Hi, I'm Leah Caruso with Strive Rehabilitation, inviting you to join me Thursday at 11 a.m. for Health Matters. Ocala Health and Strive have teamed up to bring you the latest information on good health services available to you right here at home. This vital information will help you make informed decisions about your health. So don't forget to join me here at 11 a.m. Thursday. It's news you can use from Ocala Health, Strive, and your friends here at WOCA.
Your home is safe, or is it? AA Lock, Dock, and Security. The name has been a staple in Ocala since 1985. Do you have the right equipment in place to have peace of mind when you are at home or away? AA Lock, Dock, and Security has the right people to install and monitor your home or business. Call today for a free on-site security analysis. Call 867-1965. AA Lock, Dock, and Security, 219 Northwest 10th Street, 867-1965.
Your weekends are getting a little retooled.
Swear to God, not making a joke.
Check this out.
New shows?
Check.
We are Blackboard.
Some new talent?
Check.
Let's welcome the guys.
Let's get it going.
Arnie Spanier.
Unbelievable.
TJ.